Hello, DramaFest. This year at DramaFest, as you know, we had to go online. But despite that, we did not want to miss the opportunity to showcase student work from across the province. And so we adapted. And with the help of Cape Breton University and the Boardmoor Theatre, we took our showcase to YouTube. Thank you so much to everyone who worked on these shows. We know how much hard work goes into a show in a regular year, so seriously, congratulations to all of you. All right, DramaFest, let's get to it.
Here at Cape Breton University, tradition never stands still. Ours is a tradition of possibility, inspiring us to become the leaders of tomorrow and creating a world we can be proud of. Ours is a tradition of new, and everyone is welcome.
You've been condemned to death by lethal injection upon the jury's verdict of your guilt for the murder of Phoebe Fisher. Is there a statement you'd like to make before the sentence of the court is carried out? You've been condemned.
Focused on that, other things, but one thing that's predominant, I'm hungry. What do you reckon? Takeout?
Focus on your gut.
Yeah, a lot of things are pressing. Are you not hungry?
I don't think I could eat right now, Darius.
All right. We have an issue.
There, our daughter just died.
Understand that, Ellie.
You haven't shown an ounce of sympathy. You haven't tried to comfort me.
Everyone has their own types of grief. I have mine, you have yours. I try to show it a bit less. And I feel it'd be better to move on.
How can I move on when my daughter's dead?
Our daughter's dead! Don't rob me of this! Don't think that I don't feel for this. But we need to stay strong. Move on.
just think there's something I could have done more. I could have... There's so much I could have done more.
What do you mean? There's nothing you could have done. It wasn't your fault.
That, no, she stopped going to Catholic school. That was the first sign. You always gotta go to Catholic school.
I only went because it made you feel happy.
Well, I could have... Ever since your mom left, I should have taken better care. I should have paid attention.
She was still the same person. I used to sit with her every night before going to bed. She would still comfort me during thunderstorms. It wasn't your fault.
Just wish I could hear her say that she's sorry.
Fisher?
Hi, Josie.
Did you know Phoebe by any chance?
I've seen her around school and around the neighborhood, but I don't think we were friends.
Did Darcy know her at all?
I think they're in some of the same classes, but they never really hung out.
I see. Are you and your dad moving?
Yeah, it's, the last few weeks have been difficult, and we can't stay here, all the memories, and we need to give you guys some space to,
move on?
Yeah.
Well, if you and your dad need anything, my door's on something, okay?
Could you actually help me grab the last box?
Yeah.
It's kind of heavy.
Sure.
Darcy?
I think that's Phoebe's fourth birthday. That's my backyard.
Yeah, I think I remember that. Her smile warmed my heart. Her laugh could always light up rooms. Phoebe's teachers always said she was a good student. She always did her homework. She always studied hard. She'd always help out around the neighborhood, lending a hand to anyone in need. She's an amazing person.
and I would know best.
These last few weeks have been difficult, but we're settling in quite nicely. Dad unpacked some of Darcy's stuff in her room. I think he forgot. I miss her. She was not only my role model, but my best friend. And ever since Mom left, I looked up to her. And I know she feels sorry for what she did.
After the death of my daughter, and the righteousness delivered upon her killer, I started writing letters to my wife, trying to get her to move on and show some form of grief. But for all the times that I tell her to move on, I ask the question if I am even capable. It's been a few months since the move. I'm settled down into a labor job. My body is tiring, and it keeps my mind busy, so that's good. I couldn't bear to throw Darcy's stuff away, but once I caught Josie looking at me, I stopped unpacking it. I'll get back to that later. I just miss those mornings that I used to have with them. They'd fight over the last piece of bacon, they'd squabble around, and then they'd head off to school. I just wish I could hear her say I'm sorry, even in a dream.